Welcome to part 4 of Blogger Plus AdSense tutorial series. You are going to learn how to design and create a favicon or logo for your Blogger website. You may skip to each timestamp if you know how to set up these things already. Since this is a full steps-by-steps tutorial series, I will show you how to set up a simple Blogger site and get Google AdSense approval. Let's dive in right now. I forgot to update my favicon after my site was connected to Google Analytics in the part 2 video of BAT. Let me upload the favicon inside Blogger settings here. Click this blue favicon, and this is the place to upload and publish your website logo. You have to ensure that the favicon file you upload to Blogger is a square image with a size of less than 100 kilobytes. If you don't know how to create a custom logo for your website, you can try these 4 easy ways I'm showing in this video. Open Google Chrome, just search free logo design on Google, and there are lots of alternatives. I choose the first few results here to show you the ways to create favicons. Inside freelogodesign.org, key in your blog name under enter your company name, and select the categories you like. I'm choosing business and consulting for my Blogger site, then press get started to continue. Choose your favorite or suitable design here, or you can change the categories for a new logo pattern. I randomly choose one of them and click it to make some design. Change the color, the text fonts, add or remove any shapes to make your logo looks more suitable on your Blogger website. Press download on the upper side to proceed. You can download your Blogger favicon in PNG file format as a square image of 200 pixels. Fill in your first name and email address to download the favicon. Wait for a few seconds, and now my favicon is ready. Let's move on to the next logo design website. Same as what I have done just now. Enter your blog name as company name, and select your main topic after that. This time I fill in finance and enter your industry. Click design to get numerous logo designs. I select the first design, and this is where I can edit this logo. Click download this logo. It requires users to sign up an account before downloading the logo. You may fill in your email address and password to sign up for an account and download this logo. But I'm too lazy to do it again, just like what I have done in the last example, so I just skip it. Other than these logo design websites, you may also use Canva to design a Blogger favicon or logo. Search for Canva on Google Chrome, and then click the website. Click start designing a custom logo inside this purple box, and you can start designing the favicon. You can take the examples provided on the sidebar, like what I did here, to save some of your time to design a logo from blank. Adjust some text, font, position, images, or shapes until you get a good favicon design for your Blogger website. Press download and select PNG. Click the purple box to download this logo design. Since we can only upload a small square image as a favicon on the Blogger site, you can't really have an animated logo or favicon inside Blogger. There are still many ways to create icons, like using Photoshop or any editing tools, and I use PowerPoint to design the logo of Jaxx Blogger site, as what I'm showing you here. You may use the shapes and text here to design a logo you like. I have a good design now and I'm satisfied with it, so let me turn it into an image that fulfills what Blogger required. I'm using Photoscape here to make it into a square image with a transparent background. Save the favicon design, and now I can upload it to the Blogger site. Under Configure Favicon, choose the file I just saved and press Save to upload the favicon. So you can see my favicon was uploaded successfully, and soon the Blogger icon on the tab will be changed to this favicon. That's all for part 4 of Blogger Plus AdSense tutorial series. Feel free to ask me something in the comment section if you still have any doubts about Blogger creation and setup. Finally, you are going to learn how to write and publish a content post on Blogger and get Google AdSense approval in part 5 of the BAT series. By the way, once my YouTube channel hits 1,000 subs and 4,000 hours of watch time, I will pick one subscriber of this YouTube channel and award you something. If you are the lucky one, I will help you to get Google AdSense approval free. Just make sure you click the subscribe button, leave a like and comment in any Google AdSense related video to be eligible for this lucky draw. Before we move on to the next YouTube tutorial video, tell me which factors you think are the most important factor to get Google AdSense approval on a website. A. Daily traffic. B. Number of posts. C. Website theme. Or D. Content quality. Leave your choice in the comment section, and I will create a video to specifically talk about the most popular option after the end of this Blogger Plus AdSense tutorial series. You are the one to decide which content you want to see, so choose it wisely. Click the watch list on your left to watch the next part of BAT series, or click the watch list on your right to learn more about Google AdSense and the ways to fix policy violations on Google AdSense. Goodbye and have a nice day.